Strangers. I don't normally work for strangers, but this client is willing to pay a premium, and turning down that kind of money would be almost irresponsible of me. My client's after a stone. He claims it's rare, highly valued, and of course, like anything worth stealing in this city, it's owned by the noble blood. The Voltas are one of the city's more popular families, mostly known for their business in exotic trade. According to my client, they're keeping the stone inside an old watchtower, no doubt well guarded, and far from the reach of their rivals. Lucky for me, I've got a map of the place and it looks like there's a quiet way in through a garden house around back. Once I'm inside, I'll need to climb the tower and grab the stone. Ideally, before any of their bloodhounds catch on to me. Stealing from noble houses is risky, but there's an upside to this job. I'll probably get a nice view of the city from all the way up there.
This is Volta and the Stone. Recent mission that's come out. Everybody seems to be raving and raving about like some sort of lunatics. So I figured, you know, I would play it, but I did it off camera. So this is not a blind playthrough. It's fake like a Canal Street watch. So make sure that no strange people in suits come down and sit down on your kazoos. Okay, good. So, people are like, you know, praising this one pretty highly. Hey, there's a place up there that I don't think I've ever been to. That's crazy, I'll have to go there later. But yeah, they're praising it pretty highly. So I played it. And you know, first impression, you know, the title screen was like, wow, this is a pretty cool title screen. First impression playing the game was like, well, it doesn't look that blow your mind. I mean, it's solid, you know. You're starting on a canal or some architecture. I mean, I guess that looks pretty, but, you know, it doesn't quite look like the beginning of, House of Locked Secrets or nothing. So, I was just like, well, you know, I guess I'll just keep playing and maybe jump in the water and get wet. It sounds like a stupendous plan. So, I did. And guess what happened? I didn't get wet because this is some sort of video game, and despite what Fran Bo might have you believe, video games are not real, and if you're uncomfortable during them, you should probably go see your doctor and tell them what mean game designers have done to your conscience-ment. You'll notice that there's a lot of crates around, which is something that I noticed, and I figured, well, maybe you could stack them or something, but then I remembered that stacking crates in the dark mod might or might not be kind of weird because of actual physics, like, actually happening, so then again, well, I don't know. Who knows? So I didn't really ever bother. It was weird. But it looks like I could get up there. I never have before. I did. I guess. I don't know. Just ignore me. I'm clearly the knowledgeable tangentleman about this mission. Yeah, I guess I did get up here then. Whoop-de-doo. Also, I rebound my keys to something better? More within reach? Although, there's only so many I could do, and I couldn't really map the M key to anything more within reach, really, because, goddamn, the dark mod has a lot of keys. It's a lot of keys, bro. From her freeze, bro. Okay, so that's that place. In case you wanted to see that place, there's these cool-looking machines that are just spinning around at such a frame rate.
These guys look like City Watch. They'll leave me be as long as I don't do anything stupid.
Move along now.
Alright, I think these guys had some sort of conversation I missed. I don't know. I don't know. I fiddled with the sound levels to try to make conversations hearable. Those notes don't say anything, they're just notes. And, now this is version 1.1. And it's the only one I've played. Now, people have been complaining about, like, misaligned textures and stuff. Now, I only saw one, and it was off in a corner some crazy place where you'd never notice. So maybe version 1.1 fixed all of that or something. Or people were just overreacting. I don't know. But I don't think that's wood, though. Well, it could be, but it looks kind of metal-ish to me. So I won't be playing it in this Britney Spears-a-thon. Alrighty. Yeah, those watch, I don't know why they were knocking on the door. I guess, you know, they're city watch and they knock on doors and that's kind of what they do or something. Didn't I not ever go here ever? I don't know. I mean, there's obviously a house that I need to get to. That's a pretty sky. I would stroke its hair any day in loving remembrance of its hair being unstroked. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So if you go that way, you end up going that way, and I guess you can go that way if you want. I don't know. Broken. Well, it's not broken, but I'm going to say that it is, because, you know, inspiration manifestation is an episode of something, and I wouldn't want to be claimed that I was having an episode of something, would I? No. Horrid. If only I could get up on that balcony, I could fall through like that other guy named Brian. And here's a bunch of, you know, scrawlings, possibly of pagan origin. I don't... No, there's a guy with a big long tongue and or a horn sticking out of his mouth. Pretty, inconvenient and unpractical there. I don't know, it's a bunch of scratchings. See, there's a lot of these scratchings around and I never really figured out what they meant. They're sometimes in very weird places, you understand, so you can understand how me figuring could figure very heavily into this. So there's my goal, there's the V for Volta thing, but I can't get in the front gate. Because, you know, you can't get in the front gate because it doesn't have a switch. It's the most secure gate you could think of. So, this is a window. Oh, yeah. Don't get it pulled there, buddy. In case you were wondering what a window looks like. So, I think... No, it's not here either. Well, I don't know. If I find the misaligned texture, the single one I ever saw, I'll point it out to you. But then again, I tend not to notice these things that much. So, you know... Don't go listening to me. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, this is cool. This mission is very thiefy, just as people are saying. There's another healing potion. Some people are also saying it's a bit easy. I don't know. I like easy, personally. I don't mind that in any way at all. I complain about hard all the time, so no trouble there if it is. I don't really know, but I'll try not to knock out quite so many people this time around, I guess. Okay. Freaking fantastic. So that's a window up there, yeah, like in case you were wondering. Yes, so this time I think I'll try going up. Oh, you know what? I should have bought two rope arrows. Well, not really. I don't need them. I know that for a fact. But it's just a comfort food. Two rope arrows. Put them inside a bun. You can outdo McDonald's and they'll sue you for outdoing them. Because that's pretty much how competition works these days. Because it's not gold. Because, you know, that's just what's going to happen when you tell people to compete with each other. You know, they're going to screw each other over because nobody wants to compete. It's pretty hilarious. Especially with non-scarce resources like digital bits. But anyways, yeah, so that's, you know, this is a room. There's a guy sleeping. He's got some muddy boots, and that's mud, not blood. Make sure you don't put those words together or you'll get banned for adult content, I'm sure. So, anyways, yeah. This is actually really cool, because you see, you gotta pick this door, so even thought was even given to, like, ghosters of people want to play Supreme or whatever, where... Actually, that's nowhere in the rules at all. Even Supreme doesn't have a rule about not picking doors. But, I mean, in case you don't want to pick the door, for whatever reason, you don't have to, you know? And it's basically what I'm trying to say here. So, this is, like, the bar or, like, whatever the hell it is. I don't know. It's a place. Anyway, and, you know, you can go down here, and there's some sort of secret door, which I actually found the switch before I found the door, and I was just like, arg, it's one of those switches that sounds like something's happening, and I looked all around the room, and I couldn't find it, so then I went down here and I found it. It was just, like, freaking fantastic. Boop, oh, there's the boop on the nose fairy. Looks suspiciously like some sort of small, tiny Adora horse, but never nobody mind that. Okay. So now we're in the secret cellar. Oh man, that light is so easy to turn on and off when I'm moving. the magic of keys and stuff. There's the estate key, in case I want an estate key. I don't know, there's a flash bomb. I'm never gonna use it, because useless in the dark mod. I will bear Burnick's injuries no longer. How dare that quack insist he has a keg of Burnaby, yet refuses my offer to officiate the purchase or to feed him breadcrumbs. Revenge will be my repayment. So, somebody has a keg, but refuses to officiate the purchase. Does that mean he refuses to sell it or whatever? I don't know. I guess this could be an amusing way to officiate something. So I'll just, having taken the coins, I'll just leave. But yes, it is very thiefish, you know, and that's cool. It's pretty classic thiefish, really. I think I'm just gonna go out this door because, you know, why not? I don't care about picking. Call me a Ficky Picky, whose coach is Little Picky. And also the locks usually only take one pick, which is nice. It's a nice service being done there. So, I've just been serviced. Also, what the hell is this? Did I just go in there? Like, okay, I went over here and I sort of... Yeah, I guess that place must just be... Yeah, the other room... Okay, so, good. Never mind. Let's carry on here and, attempt to go forward. Except not. I don't know. I mean, this city, you know, now that I play it a second time, it does look pretty good. Yeah, the guys don't care about me. Because I think this is some sort of... Oh yeah, this is another way up. See, it's really, really cool. The thing that really struck me about this mission more than anything else is that how many ways there are to move around. It's really, really nicely done. It's very, very much like Classic Thief in that regard. There's always another way in, as the screen said. And, you know, I mean, you can go in here, you can rope up there, you can pick the lock, and that's not just here. That theme holds throughout the entire mission. There's all manner of ways. I'm just going to accept that. All manner of ways to get around. So, you know, you're not just linearly coming across situations... And situations, like, I mean, this would be a ghoster's paradise. Just so much creativity. I mean, you could, if you find yourself stuck, you can always come at it from like 3, 4, or 5 other different ways. And I'm sure you could probably ghost this mission. I mean, I'm just thinking probably. I don't think there's anything that would preclude it. I don't think so. I think you can put everything back and... Yeah. So, I really like that. And, there's, yeah, that moon. It's a pretty moon. It's sort of a reddish Mars-looking moon, because it actually is Mars, because Mars is actually a moon. When will scientists wake up and realize it? If you go on Stack Overflow, please use Element Hiding Helper for AdBlock Plus to block out the hot network questions, as there's some really stupid shit in there. Stick to the programming questions for good stuff, and yeah, you take it from your old Uncle Fen. So this is JS Importer. His name happens to be his profession. It's pretty convenient. So I really like that... Oh, I really like that lock is weirdly placed. It looks old.
Huh. An electric floor tile seems a little excessive. But I guess even forged artwork can turn a profit in this city.
Forged or foraged? How do you know it's forged or foraged? Oh, God. Off to a bad start with that. Very much worse than it was before. Oh, there's another rope here. Okay, good. So, yeah. I don't know. It used to be easy for me to jump over that, but I guess not. So, yeah, there's nothing in here or something. I guess that's sometimes the case. You know, it's forged after all. What more could I provide him? I've procured the greatest artisans in the city, yet he takes up trade with Gordif and Want. Their stock is mud, I swear! Oh, good. Okay, so that opens that up, although it doesn't turn this off. But, you know, in case you want to go out there without having to jump over a thing, you can do that, so... All this stuff is forged, I guess. Maybe it's forged steel. It's painted out of all different colored parts of forged steel. It could be. To be packaged and returned, unnecessary space... Note to receiver. Burnick Volta wishes to inform the museum that he finds the works boring and unsuitable to his taste. Now, I don't quite get this. I thought that sometimes I don't get readables because I'm trying to LP, but sometimes I don't get them even when I'm not, so I guess, hey. To be packaged and returned to the museum, I guess. So he says he finds this work boring, but I'll talk about that a bit later as we get into the house, so keep that thought in mind. There's a lady. It's awesome. Well, it's a statue of a lady. Ceci ne pas une pipe, or however the hell you say it. French is a funny language. Half the time you don't pronounce half the letters. I mean, I don't even remember if you pronounce S or T, but like, there's words that end with E and T, and you don't pronounce any of those three letters. It's pretty great. So yeah, I mean, the loot is there, but it's not doled out excessively. You know, your rewards are pretty reward-shaped, like, here you go, son. Here you go, son. So that's, you know, it's kind of neat. It's letting you know that it's not the main event. It's just a little, amuse-bouche, not amuse-bouche, and not buff. It's buff and amuse-bouche. Please be ridiculous. So, okay. The map. Here's the map. It's a back way in. There's the garden house. So, I am kind of... So, there you can see the porters on the right. So, I'm kind of around just above that line that says gate should be climbable. I'm just before that. So, here's the estate. Now, you can see the back way in circled there. Now, here's what really impresses me about the mission is that it circles this back way in, which is way over this way, and really makes you go over there like that's the way in. But even then, there's other ways in. Actually, there's three ways in, as far as I know. There's back there, there's over here, and then there's like even farther back there. So, I mean, that's just awesome for some reason, because I say so. So, oh yeah, I need the estate key. So if you didn't get the estate key, I guess maybe you could get in that other way. But yes, now I'm in the estate. So, it says through the garden house, but yeah, like, it's kind of weird that it wants you to go there specifically, but you can just go here. Oh yeah, I guess this carpet is kind of floating there. Hey, whatever, I didn't notice it the first time, so it doesn't count. Okay, so this is now the bathhouse that we're in. So you could go in here too. However, I think I'm just gonna go in the other way because, you know, why the heck not? Gambling is family fun for all. They're actually getting kind of interesting about... Oh, there's a floating light. That's also kind of interesting. I went to the grocery store and... you know what? I'm not gonna accept that. I've got two here. I went to the grocery store. It was amazing! Okay, so here I am here, so you can actually climb up there too if you want through those crates, but just to show you kind of where I am, I'm kind of over here, which wherever the hell it... Yeah, there's the importers right up there, so I go down the stairs and I think I might have missed the horrible misaligned texture. It's rotten. Well, maybe not. Anyway, that's one way up. Nice detailing. This mission has subtle things about it. You know, when I first played it, I'm like, oh, I don't know, it doesn't look that great, but it kind of does. And there's different lighting when you go in different areas. You know how sometimes the lighting gets light or dark when you go outside and inside? That's taken advantage of here, and some people like it, some people don't, according to the thread. Seems to be a bit of a split. I think it's kind of cool, but I guess it does seem a bit, like maybe some people could not think it's cool. Yeah, I don't friggin' know, but hey, anyways. So we continue around here. And once again, it's just, you know, doors aren't nothing. And yeah. I don't know. Oh yeah, there's people saying, yeah, and other such stuff. Oh. That texture sure is a thing. So anyways, the garden house around back is... somewhere? Where is it? Where the hell am I? Oh, there it is. Yeah, okay, there it is. So, the one texture, I believe it'll be over here. The one misaligned texture I saw is this. And I mean, most people probably wouldn't see it. I don't know. That's the only one I personally noticed, but you know, who knows? I might notice more. I don't friggin' know. So, there's one way in through here, and another way in through here. So I guess you could consider this just one way with two windows. I don't know, but whatever. Yeah, you don't need the estate key. So yeah. Options. That's the pretty much the name of this freaking mission. It should have been called Options, the Mission. I would have liked it a lot more. Let me tell you. So here's the garden house. And lots of nude asses, as it were. I think we all know that the acid come to mean God and implement. And there's this generator. Now, for some reason, these plaques have a tiny miniature backwards map on them, like with backwards text, and it looks to be Latin or something. I have no idea what is the deal with that. Sure. Oh, wait, yeah, okay. So here's the generator, in case you want a generator. This is for you. It's kind of just the walking simulator portion where you just walk around and look. I don't know, it looks pretty, but... what? Who knows? Oh, God. So yeah, there's nothing really much out here, apparently. It's actually kind of weird, now that I come to think of it. Why would it be locked? You know? There's... could be some secret. I haven't found any myself, but... well... I don't know. It's strange. You can't even, like, turn these generators off or anything. So I just have no real particular idea what's going on here, but I guess I'll just ignore that and carry on or something. Okay. Oh, and here's an apple. It's not a celebration apple, but you can eat it, so, you know, no problem. Maybe it even heals you. I didn't actually look there, but hey, whatever. Yep. So, probably might, end up going skydiving at some point here, you know, because why not? I think you can't do nothing with these. Oh, you can. Blatantly can. So this is the North Chamber, but I won't be going here yet because that's just getting ahead of myself. Instead I'll go down here because that seems to be quite before myself. Time traveling backwards is the only way to go. Yeah, you see it's all kind of red colored now. You know, depending on your predisposition, you can put the red back in predisposition. And so on and so forth. So, you know. Yeah, just one little picky had their house blown down, but unfortunately, love turned the world into a video game and giggled pinkly whilst you shot a whole bunch of people to bits, but it's okay, because they're not real people. They're heaven smiles. Melinda, Lady Hansla lost a family ring during her visit. She believes it may have been in the bathhouse. If you should find the ring during your duties this evening, bring it to me immediately, Percy. Yeah. So, anyways, yeah, it's stupid, so yeah, let's go up this ladder and proclaim it. I'm gonna levitate up to the roof, but unfortunately, by levitating, I mean I'm going to use the help of a ladder. Some might consider that cheating. I consider it tool-assisted speedrunning. So, shove that up your nose hole. Thank you. So, yeah, you can go on the roof even. I mean, there's, like, millions of ways around everywhere. I mean, this is a completely different way already than I took when I play this off camera. So, already, I'm just like, whoa, man. So, yeah, this is going to be above that room. Like, it's so not obvious. I think I want to go to the swimming pool type portion because there's a ring there. And it's kind of hunt the pixely, but the pool isn't too big, so it's not that huge a deal, you understand? So, yes. Also, there's a certain person walking around here, which I am going to refrain from blackjacking. It's not him, but, you know, there is one, just in case you wanted to know. You can even get in through this window from outside, too. I mean, just, like, the sheer amount of ways to move around is incredible. So, I'm gonna go up here first. I mean, I went here way later. Like, this, yeah, I don't want to repeat myself, but yeah, it's pretty amazing. Total non-linearity. It's just great. I mean, we're going to the tower. Oh, come on. I was able to do this before. Come on. I was. We're going to the tower. So that part is sort of, you know, it's a place we gotta go to. And it's going to be sort of linear-ish, but, you know, whatever. There's that little ding in the wall there. But never mind that. We'll see about that in one moment. Wait a minute. Oh. Okay. You have to switch it open. So here's a secret. And I found this by myself. BT dubs. To use some strange sort of hip kid saying these days slang. So it's the secret, and there's some loot, there's a turnip, and there's a note, and it goes, up here be most treasured hiding place. Stare at the Fat Man Olsen's pumpkin face. Take Fat Man Olsen's keepers he loves most. Watch Fat Man Olsen howls at mine ghosts. It's not that great a meter, but hey, I have no idea what the hell this note is referring to, I'll be honest with you. Spoiler. Yeah, you can look at that. I have no idea who Fat Man Olsen is. I don't have anybody named Olsen in these readables. I can't see anybody fat. Well, there's the engineer. Spoiler, he's fat, but, like, I don't see how that has to do with it. The funny thing is, I know what this key does. And I don't even know why it does what it does. But it's nothing to do with this note. So I really have absolutely no clue what the hell this thing is on about. But hey, it's a secret, so
whatever.
I might end up, bungee jumping, and nobody wants that. So yeah, you gotta also not turn your light on as much if you wanna, like, not get deaded. Which, who knows, you might wanna get deaded. I mean, if you're being screwed over very hard by your neighbor the screwdriver, and then you go beat the shit out of him because he screwed your wife, who is some kind of plank, because obviously it's very one-sided, it's only his fault. Oh yeah, these floors, they can get loud, just in case you wanted to know. So yes, where are you? What? Oh! He's here. Okay, this is the engineer. He's got a key on him. And he just filled the pool up. I didn't see that last time. But I heard that that's what happens. Come on, come on. Kind of want your key. Maybe I'll get it later. I don't know. But, he does that in order to tell you that that's a thing you can do.
A noise?
Oh, shit. Okay. I'm gonna let you be, though. Okay, there's... Oh, he's good and sticky. But he does have his engineer's logbook, so that's... That's cool. Please leave. I don't want to be caught here reading in the dark while you think we're playing hide-and-seek in the dark. That's nonsense, sir.
I guess I was wrong.
Yep. Okay, so. I can't have time to read this. Oops. Okay. Engineer log, mercury is a poisonous substance. What? Okay, please.
Ah, hidden switches. Sounds like the Voltas are going through a lot of trouble to keep the stone a secret.
Yeah, please put that up after the book, thank you. Painting in Lord Burnick's chambers to be sent to JS Importers. Valuable, do not drop this time. Security door in second floor gallery needs oil. Melinda might have the key. Remember that too. I'll be looking for that later. The gardener requested 2 tons of soil to be delivered. 2 tons! What are we to do with all that earth? I think that's not important, but I'm not sure. I don't know, maybe they're burying a body, who knows. Percy requested that a full check be done on the tower security switches. Bathhouse, library, and steward's room. Now, when I first played, I came in here at first, and I actually... I found this first right off the bat without even knowing about the switches or anything. I didn't see the engineer come in here or anything, so that just goes to show how differently this mission can go. But you gotta lower the thing. That lowers it, and this raises it. Slightly odd, but yeah. It's pretty cool. Oh, there's another pagany symbol. Oh, maybe they're in, like, in rooms. So hit that. And it looks like it's like a 1 and there's gonna be a 2 and a 3, but they all look like 1 spoilers. I'm just spoiling things left and right, aren't I? Okay, but there's a ring, and I think it's somewhere around this kind of direction. Okay, so that texture is misaligned too. Great, so I've seen 2, yeah. But you know what? Whatever. Okay, I guess there's a bunch. You know what? I didn't notice them. I'm noticing them now. But you know, whatever. I mean, it's not a huge deal. I mean, yeah, they could stand to be cleaned up. But I mean, honestly, it doesn't kill the thing, does it? No. No, no, it doesn't. So, yeah, here we are back where it was. Now, there's a lot of AIs running around. Some people are saying that there's not enough. I don't know. I think there's just the perfect amount, if you ask me. But nobody asked me, so. Oh no. Okay, that was not the greatest thief move ever.
No point in bringing it up. They'd never listen to me anyway.
Good. No. I was hoping it was nothing. Well, whatever it was, I can't see anything now.
Okay. That didn't happen. But then again, I didn't go for the statue last time either, so. I love this. Okay. Yeah, this mission just gets better with other playthroughs. I'm just realizing now. Okay. So I think somebody comes in and turns this light on.
When are they gonna send someone to relieve me?
Relieve you, eh? You gotta pay extra for that. Okay, that's the court key. I must deny any request to attend the Bagsby Parade tomorrow on account of Lady Volta's arrival. Sorry, boys, be vigilant. Corporal Tennis Ball. So, I think... I don't know. I feel like I don't want to knock everybody out this time. I want to play it a bit more thiefishly, so I'm not going to. How'd you like that? Hey. Tomorrow, the Ambient Prologue public beta gets released. How'd you like that? Hey. Good. So, yeah, it's just the kind of mission you can just sort of traipse around anywhere. It is the Zelda Breath of the Wild of missions, except way better, because I don't trust any sort of big money hype trains at all these days. You know, whatever. Seriously, views kind of look good sometimes, but do we really need survival elements? I don't know. Do we really need people saying, Link, wake up, and I'm an old man, blah, blah, blah? I don't know, man. I'm a young man. People keep calling me that. 30 doesn't seem young to me. Seems like some sort of despicable fool to live to be 30 years old. That's okay. I might end up on the wrong end of a cannon like Blackadder, and that'd be a way to go out. The wrong end of cannon. You know what? I'm not going that way because I end up triggering a conversation that I can't freaking hear. So, never mind. I'm going to go downstairs to hear it. Okay. Also, I think I'm going to temporarily turn up this sound volume to hear it, even though it also makes every other sound louder. I don't know how Thief could do this just perfectly, and the dark mod just cannot get the levels right. I mean, Thief doesn't even need multiple sliders. It has ambient and non-ambient, but I mean, conversations are always good enough. Volume, duh. So yeah, this is a hallway, there's not much in it. It's pretty amazing.
She's not gonna be happy about this.
About what? What the hell are you running around for? Oh, whatever. I'm here to listen, I'm here to learn, sir, and etc.
Nothing left in the kitchen when I get
God and Master Bernick's brew. Though the Master does have a request, he's asked that you ascend the tower and kindly throw thyself from it. I'm inclined to agree with him.
Do not bait me, Captain, for by the crown I will have thee plucked. This house shall remain steadfast during these trying times.
You don't believe all of that foul business about an attack from pagans, do you? You're as crazy as Bernick, old man.
Just follow your orders, Captain, and have your guard ready for Lady Volta's arrival on the morrow.
Go about your business.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
All right. I don't know, maybe this isn't too loud. Well, whatever. Okay, let's just bump that down. Ish or something. Sound good. Okay, so this is the room wherein you always get caught when you try to take the magnificent piece of loot over there. It's, in other words, the Great Hall. Not the Grand Hall, but the Great Hall. So, you know, be careful who you annoy in this hall. Because it wouldn't be pretty great if you did, I guess. I don't freaking know, but yes. This is what I want to do, and I don't think there is a key for this. Not even the secret key. You have to pick it. And oh, you can pick it by leaning in the dark mode. That's interesting. He's got a key too. It's probably just another state key. But yeah, this is pretty tricky. I didn't manage to do this without knocking everybody out last time, so let's see if I can this time. Oh, shit. There's a guy with a torch that comes through here, but I guess I missaw. But there definitely is one, so yeah, it's pretty challenging. But, you know, as it should be. As it's some sort of evil crown or something.
Is that something over there?
Okay, there it is. Shoot. Should be dark enough, just dark enough. Get out of here. Damn it, I shouldn't have got greedy. As a matter of interest, I don't have moss arrows either, so just, you know.
Is that something over
just
there?
Just saying. Can they see me through this? Could be. Damn it. Pretty tense. Okay.
still. Should be good. Alright. Good. Good, and I could even close it, I guess, if I wanted. Yeah, okay. Good. Oh, that is cool. I enjoyed that. That's my kind of challenge. So I guess there's some urns there for some reason, because, you know, the boss has earned his throne. Anyway, he's earned his throne, so enough of that. Let's go get a gift. Hopefully it won't smoke out our houses and destroy our plants. The seeing eye gift from High Counselor Orin. This is Orin, not Olsen, please note. Poulet avec œuf d'or. Yes, so unfortunately, yeah. Maybe the fat man is referring to a painting. Perhaps I've already taken it even. Whoa, shit. Oh, you.
This ends now.
God damn it. God damn it, man. God damn it, man. And that nice floating sword, too, sir. Very good. Okay, so don't go out that door. Ever. Lesson learned. Don't go out that door. We should write it down in a door Bible where, shoot. All the scholared will learn how to be schooled in the art of not opening that door over there. They'll spend centuries trying to figure out what I meant by that door and what I meant by over there. It will just be so delicious that it'll just be hilarious. Okay, so yeah, lots of textures aren't allowed. That's weird. I didn't even notice the first time. I mean, the overall look is good, so eh, whatever. I mean, textures are all misaligned in Original Thief 2. It's just another way that it's thiefy, you see? Totally, yes. So, I haven't looked at my map very much, but I'm now on the second floor, and I'm in the bottom right corner right near Burnick's room, because there's a spa room. Now, they call this upper portion the spa room and the lower one the bathhouse, but there's absolutely no spa up here. All it is just one tiny little walkway and then some rafters. It's utterly a silly thing to say. But you can see those color changes. Now, the funny thing is, I can actually get into Burnick's room just by kind of hugging the door. It is actually dark enough, as long as that guy's turned away that way-ish. Maybe even if he's here. It is actually dark enough for me to do that, but that's not really how you're supposed to do it. So I'm gonna do it the way I'm supposed to do it, okay? Okay. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that hurt. Okay. So, yeah. You gotta go up here. Actually, I think there might be some candlestick or something over there. Maybe not. I don't know. I'll check there later. But, oh, shit. Gotta be seen over here. Oh, God damn it. Okay. Okay. See, you notice this hole. I mean, like, I found all this stuff myself. In fact, there's one thing I haven't found. Actually, well, there's that note in the secret about Lord Olsen, Fat Man Olsen. I don't know what the hell that is. So if that is indeed anything, then I haven't discovered that. Another thing I haven't discovered, I'll show off later, I guess. But no! What is wrong with you? He notices the rope, doesn't he? That's funny. That doesn't happen in Thief. Well, maybe not. I don't really know. But yeah, it's a nice rope going down right in front of your face. Very mysterious! In the wisdom of trees, it sure is. Alright. Well, he can take out his sword. Whatever. I don't care if he does. $10,000 not. So this is an attic. Amazing, I know. And if you want, you can jump over here and get like a little pagan skull. Cause pagan's gotta be murdered. It's a pagan priest. Although it's probably more properly a shaman. But what do these racist buggers know about that? Yeah, it's very strange. Yeah, because when I was up here last time, everybody was already unconscious and a-snoring, so okay, so you can go here, or you can go here. Now, there's another pagan symbol. They really don't have much meaning. I guess it just means, hey, a pagan has infiltrated or something. I don't know. But I didn't realize this switch was here the first time, so I ended up going in here through the regular ground door. Now, as you can see, this room's pretty spookerific, so I'm not going here yet. First off, I'm gonna just kind of go here and show you guys what's up here. I found this kind of a missed opportunity, and I'll show you why, because this is right above this guy here, and it's pretty beautiful and strange, though. It's just a bunch of lit walls. Smark. It's a smart mark. S mark. I guess it's a lion with S mark on it. Like, why not? But anyways, the thing is, and maybe it's because this is expert, but that guy has got a helmet that you can't knock him out ever. But there's this glass ground, and there's these two crates placed very conspicuously here. So I'm guessing maybe on lower difficulties, and I don't know this for a fact, but maybe on lower difficulties, you can go like... Dang. Okay, he's right there. So maybe on lower difficulties, you can knock him out by pushing this crate down. Because I thought it was rather disappointing and strange that it really looks like you can, but you just can't, man. You just can't, Frodo. So I think it kind of landed on his head. I don't know. Off camera, I did a test where it definitely landed right on his head and it didn't knock him out. So yeah. Anyways, that's a cool thing that you can't do, although it looks like you can. So anyways, yeah. Ooh. So I guess I'll just fall down and get hurt yet again or something. God damn it. How inconvenient. Okay. So... this is the Volta Chambers. There's a headless dude who's picking something out of a bowl. And, yeah. Why not, right? I think... yeah, that actually heals you quite a lot. Well, okay. My dearest Leandra, I fear the grandsire's statue has suffered a deplorable fate. With great sadness, I must confess that our beloved steward, Percy, is to blame. Undoubtedly, with no B, punishment was due, and thus I've ordered him to be thrown from the tower. I will call for Jaos on the morrow and have new likenesses... have new likeness of the statue made. Your beloved Bernick. So, I don't know if he's telling the truth or what. It's kind of a strange story, but that doesn't look like a fat man Burke to me. Or Olsen, or, you know, whatever. But somebody's been drinking, and it looks like this guy was drugged by somebody. Percy, maybe? I don't quite understand what's going on here, but then I never do, so whatever. There's a Bernick's quarters key, and there's some loot, and, you know, typically stingy sort of dole outs. But this appears to be kind of like it. So I don't have a really clear idea of what the hell went on here, but... hey, it's, you know, mysterious and full of equine companions, so, you know, why not? So you could go out here and it just leaves the place with the dude standing, or you could just go right back out the way you came. Actually, I don't need that at all. This mantling is so good. Let's attract some cute boys! Harder! Sounds like Teen Girl Squad exclamation. Harbiter! This video is now like 40-something minutes! Not quite 45, because I'll be cutting out a part where I screwed around and made a silly mistake and so forth, but by which I mean listening at conversation where you couldn't hear it. That's a mistake and silly. So... Shoot. Oh, I don't care. Especially right between the eyes. I hear that's the most effective part to shoot. But that could just be Hollywood talking. Yeah, look at these guys. Garden and garden, garden, garden. I thought the garden house was round back. Oh, get it? Oh, even if you don't, I appear to be somehow sort of half-heartedly orgasming here, so it's the best kind. So, if you need relationship tips, just go to negativerelationshiptips.com and please don't go there. It's probably not a real site, but I take no responsibility if it was. You see, I'm just making it up. And it'll be like, is your relationship sucking bad? Are you having not enough sucking in your relationship? Well then come and tell you how to deal with all these horrible problems that makes nobody want to bother. It's pretty great. Okay, so this is the thing that needs oil that Melinda might have the key for. Melinda is walking around here. Last time I knocked her out, and I don't remember getting a key off her, but, like, I don't know what the hell's gonna happen this time. I just don't know how to get in there. That's one of the things I just don't know. This is a dangerous place, also, because... you know what? Maybe that guy with the torch, maybe he's in a conversation that you end up... you know, I'll bet he's in a combo somewhere that you don't end up releasing him to walk around until you finish with the combo. That would be very convenient for me. So this, as we see, is the library. I mean, I know the map, so I'm not showing it enough. It's sort of on the bottom left corner there. And as you see here, there's another pagan symbol under the plant, which I don't know why, but... anyways, this is one of the rooms with a switch. So you see there's like a book there that you can see through. Now I clicked on all these books. Now here's the thing. Apparently the engineer comes in here and like all the rooms with switches, and he sort of switches them so that you can know where they are. Now, I didn't know that when I came here, so I just clicked every book until I found this one. So, if that was the case that you just had to do that, that'd be silly. But the engineer comes, so if you want to wait for him, and or if you know that he's supposed to do that beforehand, which you may or may not, then that's not, like, silly or whatever. So yeah. We regret to inform you that we cannot lend out Bel-Arrows, Leandra, and the Serpent. The last remaining copy of the transcript must be kept within the safety of our Athenium. Please inform Bernick Volta that he is welcome to make a visit to our library, at which time we would be delighted to show him our Bel-Arrow collection. Respectfully, the Affordium Library has great affordance and or it's cheap and cheerful. You can get some solid gold watches, probably, inside of its bowels. Because, you know... You can't, you know, wander over yonder. If it's taught us anything, it's that girls are not interested in cars at all. So if you've got a cool car, no female is going to be interested in it. I think we are accidentally being sexist in a completely different but equal way here, but don't nobody say that, okay? Great. So, now that I've done with that utterly irrelevant aside, whoa, shit.
Something moving.
Here comes Mr. Grimbug. Here comes Mr. Grin. Oh, yeah, here come the Snicker Man. He's the engineer, so let's, yeah. Also, I didn't, yeah, I knocked him out when I saw him last time I played, because, like, what the hell else are you gonna do, right? So he didn't go around. So, yeah. I'm not really sure if I would have known he was gonna go around either, because, I mean, it says on his note that he's gotta check stuff, but that doesn't necessarily mean he's gonna do it right now, but I guess you need some lateral thinking, so yeah, he probably is just gonna go up there and hit the switch. Yeah. I guess now he doesn't actually hit it, he just looks at it. It? It's that one. He would just add it, stupid dumbass. Okay, but anyways, yeah, so he doesn't actually hit it. I guess that would be too obvious, but you kind of end up knowing where it is, so, you know, no problem. Alrighty. So this is the really, really, really thief-friendly room, and not just because there's a friendly thief in the mirror. I'm talking...
Well, isn't that fancy?
Water in the toilet? Very fancy indeed, yeah. Or distorting visuals, also very fancy. Okay, so, because it's the body dump, you see? So it's very nice. Also, it's a nice little hideout type place. Wait a minute.
Should be a servant around. Just light.
Oh, that's the light flickering. No, there is a torch guy, isn't there? Is there? Is that the torch guy? I can't quite tell. Everything's kind of orange. Let me see. Just want to know if he's walking. He is! Okay, so... He wasn't in a convo. And you can't take him out. He's wearing a helmet that you can't knock out. At least I was never able to last time. So it's hysterically funny. It's some sort of disease that old Victorians claim to get. Funny, oh man. So here's the theater, not being used, I guess, because nobody really goes to the theater these days. It's too expensive and too many advertisements are acted out in real time before the audience, and nobody wants...
My eyes deceive me.
...to pay for that damn... So somebody's eyes are deceiving him. Oh. Wow, it's that guy himself, TM. Astound in amazement as he probably walked somewhere else. Maybe not, eh? Can't seem to put these lights out, though. That's some unfortunate junk. I guess I'll go up there and see if I can't, you know, murder him. Greatly. Oh, shoot. Jeez. But, like, you know, on the plus side, this is some real thief gameplay. So where the hell's that old library? There it is. I don't know if it's old, but, you know, houses are always old. I mean, who the hell ever lives in a new house? Not me. This house is from, like, the 60s. I mean, sure, it's been renovated probably a million times, but still. From the 60s. You can tell by the US-style imperial window measurements. It's astounding. So, yeah. On the other hand, maybe if I go up here... It still doesn't turn off the stage lights. Well then, oh, he left. Of course he did.
Lord Wellard has an excellent steward in his employ.
Yeah? Lord Wellen. Oh, that's funny. These guys are mentioning a specific lord by name.
Is there a noise?
Wait.
Is there a noise?
Oh, I get it now. This is... Okay, I know what room this is. Wow, that's funny. I don't think I can get him from this side, though. It's so awesome. You can get to this place even from here. Okay, I'm gonna try it, but I... Oh, you can. Nice. Okay, no problem. I'm gonna drag you off and read your stuff. Percy, I have no misgivings about your loyalty, but I forbid thee to lecture my plannings on family business. Have your staff at their readiest for my arrival tomorrow. I trust you have put an end to Cousin Burnick's plans to evict the Thing. Do not allow him to beguile you into thinking it is his birthright to do so. I fear something wicked has befallen him during these troubling times. It is critical that a full watch be kept tonight and that no one enters the tower until I arrive, Lady V. So I don't know how you can evict an inanimate object or why you would call a person a thing. I mean, that's just a road. So you might think, well, why don't I just go up in there? Well, that's just some silly nonsense, buddy old boy. Instead, I'm going to go down into the... Théâtre de Green Thumb, it is fini and over with, but that doesn't ever stop me. Are you fat old Olsen there, buddy? No, I guess not. Okay. Well, that's fine. I mean, it would be convenient if you were, but who am I to judge? I've knocked out one guy so far. I can't be a judge, you know? Judges have to go around with blackjacks hitting people in the head all the time. It's kind of part of the description. Not too many people know that, but don't you worry. Your old Uncle Fen is up on his legal matters. Hopefully, because I just committed a huge blatant lie. Very illegal. Whew. Dog. So, anyway, yes, here I am. Going back to the theater. Sort of narrating my actions, but hey, don't tell no Mandy about that. Where the hell is the theater? Oh, it's over here. Fine. No. Melinda should be kind of around here somewhere. I don't know. You, what the hell's your... There she is. Does she have a key on her? She doesn't, so... There's one other place where the key might be, but I don't remember finding it last time either, so I'm a little confused, but once I get there, which, like any other place, you can get to at any friggin' time, I'll explain myself. So yes, this is like a hidden backstage area, just in case you know, and here's, I think, maybe the only chest in the game that... No, even it has a one thing. I'm sure there's like one lock in this entire mission that has multiple lock thingies. And there's Dewdrop, but you can't take her with you. Sadly enough. And there's some sort of hat and a mirror. I mean, you can't take those with you either. Sadly enough. Also, for a mirror, it really doesn't reflect anything. It's kind of faux. So yeah, that's backstage. And I suppose, speaking of Melinda... I'll try to now go to the place where, another thing of hers may be found, because, you know, I don't know who the hell Melinda is, actually, if she's a servant or what, if she's like a, if she's the lady or something, but I can't find anything specifically marked as her room, so I'm just going to instead go around, oh, I'm actually right close to there already. Oh, shit.
Noise?
Oh, bugger pumpkin. You. Oh, please leave. I don't like these guys just standing around. It's not really gameplay, but hey, whatever, you know. It's okay. Okay. Good. It's the depository for books. Good. So this is the other place I can think of, but like I didn't find anything here last time, so yes. Melinda has a little deposit box here, is what I'm trying to say. I think. There's some sort of light switch here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, good. So, Melinda should be this one, I think. There's nothing in there. So, I just don't know where the key to that squeaky gate is. Maybe she doesn't have it and he's just like, she might for some bloody reason. I don't know, man. It's confusing and I'll probably never figure that gate out. The forum doesn't say either. By the way, just in case you were wondering that.
Do not like this cold air in my throat.
Yeah, well, welcome to somebody's world. Whoa. So you can, you know, raid the mailboxes. There's a... Oh, there's my loot goal already. There's Steward Percy. I guess the loot is pretty easy. Burnick, this is the last of it. I hope the serum relieves you of the mind's afflictions from...
What a delight.
For the edelberry only blooms in the autumn season, and my supplies are now diminished. Oh, so... He's taking it himself, and I even remember reading that. But, you know, I just forget things, so... Hey, whatever. So, yeah. Nothing that I can find, unless it's somehow down here. I guess these are like inboxes and outboxes or something. I do not know what is going on with that key to that grate. There's some sort of goldish dagger behind it, but you know, now that I've failed, I think I'm gonna leave it here. So like, see you guys next time for... Bye for now!